Hello everyone! For today's guide, we'll look at tiles and tilesets in GameMaker. As per usual, you can take a look at the playback bar or the video description for individual segments and timestamps. And if you don't already have a project of your own to follow along, you can try one of the many templates offered by GameMaker in the startup window. In this video, we'll be using the platformer template. Level 2. Tiles and tilesets. You might have noticed that a large portion of games made with GameMaker are tile-based. That is due to, in no small part, the engine's strong suit of tileset tools. First, some disambiguation. Tiles are internal rectangular elements that take on a sprite, can be placed in a grid, and can be interacted with, usually through collision. A group of tiles is a tileset, which usually have shared properties and applications, and whose sprites are aggregated in a single image. The size of these tiles is defined in the properties of the tileset and are applied directly into the layers that contain them. What does it all mean, though, in the end? It means that, rather than creating multiple objects for your level's geometry or decorations, you can just use tilesets. You can also easily organize different variations of tile textures in a single sprite, switch between different visual styles by changing a single image, and use many tile tools to make the process a lot faster, both for you and for your CPU. You'll interact with tiles and tilesets primarily through the main region of the room editor, at the center on the default layout. You can see tiles, tilesets, brushes, auto tiles, and other useful information on the right side of the screen. Before we talk about the tile tools, let's first take a look at how to access them. We first have to select a tile layer, preferably one with a tile set already selected. For more information on tile layers, refer to our Layers video, link on the card on screen and the video description. After selecting the layer, you'll have access to the Room Editor tab on the right side of the screen on the default layout. Clicking on it will grant you access to three additional tabs, all relating to tile sets and tile tools. This top part controls the size of the tool you're currently using. We'll see more of it as we cover tile placement tools. Down here, though, in the Tiles tab, we have the actual tile set. You can pan and zoom this view the same way you can with the main view of the room editor itself, so refer to our room editor video for more details. More importantly for this video, however, is the fact that this is where you select which tile you want to use for a given tool or action. Simply left-click the tile of your choice to have it selected. The first tile of the tileset, with this checkerboard pattern, is an empty tile, and is present in every single tileset. Keep that in mind if you're making a tileset of your own. Anything you put in that first spot will be ignored. You can select multiple distinct tiles by holding Ctrl, then clicking on the desired tiles. Holding Alt, then clicking on a tile will deselect it. You can also click and hold to select a rectangle's worth of tiles, and this also applies to holding Ctrl and Alt. Next up is the Brushes tab. We'll see more of it in the Brushes section of this video. The top view is your tile set, and everything mentioned for the Tiles tab still applies. The second view is your brushes, which can also be navigated through the exact same way as the regular tiles view. Lastly, we have the Libraries tab. We'll also cover it in more detail further into the video, but unlike the previous views, this one is a pair of lists for libraries that you can create for the given tileset. You can select a library by left-clicking it. You can edit those lists by clicking their corresponding edit button on the right side of the tab headers. Now that we're familiar with tile selections, let's look at the tools used to place them into your scene. Auto tile. When you create a tile set, you can also define groups of tiles meant to work together seamlessly to form various shapes. These can be used to create auto tile libraries. Auto tile is a tool where, by placing down tiles, they automatically change to whichever tile makes sense with the given shape and surroundings. For example, You can have special tiles for thin, single block lines, ceilings and floors, or inner corners between floors and walls. To create an auto tile library, select a tile layer, then on the Room Editor tab, select the Libraries tab. Clicking the pencil icon to the right of the Auto Tile Library header will take you to the Auto Tiling window, where you'll be able to create and define auto tile libraries of your own. For the scope of this video, we won't cover how to create auto tile libraries. To place down tiles using Auto Tile, select one of your libraries in the Auto Tile Library list. Alternatively, clicking on this Auto Tile button at the top of the interface or pressing A on your keyboard will automatically pick the previously selected auto tile library, or the first one on the list if none was selected before. After that, simply left-click or click and drag in your scene to place tiles. Right-clicking erases tiles you've placed while still adjusting the existing tiles. Tile Placement Tools. At the top of the Room Editor, after you've selected a tile layer, is a number of tools for helping with the placement of tiles. These are compatible with single tiles, which you select in the Tiles tab of the Room Editor window, as well as brushes, which we'll talk about later. The default tool is the Pan tool, the first button in this group, shortcut D. Left-click and hold to place down tiles in your scene. Right-click and hold to erase them. Next, we have the Eraser tool, shortcut E. It acts exactly like the right-click functionality of the pen. Left-click and hold to erase tiles. The third tool is the Fill tool, shortcut F. It fills a region of surrounding tiles with the one you have selected. This tool will try to fill every orthogonally adjacent tile equal to whatever you click, be it an empty tile or a specific one. It also has no range limit, so be careful to avoid accidentally filling your entire room at once. Next up is the Line tool, shortcut L. It lets you draw a straight line between two points in the room. Left-click and hold to start drawing the line at the desired starting position, then release at the end point of your choice. The same action, done with the right mouse button, will instead erase that line of tiles. The Rectangle tool, shortcut R, functions similarly to the Line tool. Left-click and hold to start drawing a rectangle, then release to conclude. And like before, doing that with the right mouse button will instead erase that rectangular region of tiles. Following along the toolbar at the top, we have Select Tiles, which we'll cover in the next section, and Auto Tile, which we've already covered. Afterwards, we have Tile Inheritance Tool, shortcut I. This tool applies only to sublayers of tile layers. To learn more about layer inheritance, refer to our Layers video. The Tile Inheritance Tool works similarly to the Pen tool, but instead of tiles, it controls a mask. Tiles highlighted in red will inherit the tile ID and transformations from its parent layer, while tiles that are not highlighted won't. Placing new tiles in this sublayer automatically removes them from the inheritance mask. Drawing the mask over tiles, including tiles already masked, will update them with the corresponding tile from the parent layer. All tile placement tools, with the exception of the Fill tool, can have their brush size changed in the slider in the Tiles tab, or by pressing plus and minus on your keyboard. Keep in mind that this size change acts similar to brushes, such that drawing with them applies only to multiples of the chosen size. For example, a size of 4 when using the Rectangle tool will give you rectangle regions whose sides are multiples of 4. This behavior is not present in the Eraser tool, however. Tile Selection. Once you have tiles placed in your scene, you can select them by pressing the Select Tiles button at the top bar or by pressing S on your keyboard. With this tool, you can click, hold, and release to select rectangular regions of tiles. Hold Ctrl while selecting to add to the existing selection, or hold Alt to subtract from it. Selected regions can be copied with Ctrl-C, which will place a temporary brush on your cursor, letting you place the selection into your scene multiple times over. Cutting with Ctrl-X has the same effect, except it replaces the original selection with empty tiles. Pressing Delete will simply erase the selected tiles. You can also directly apply tile transformations to your selected regions, which we'll see in the next section. Finally, as long as the tile selections are active, you can draw or erase tiles exclusively within that region. This means that other tools, such as Pen or Fill, will only take into account the region you have selected and will ignore everything outside. This is especially useful if you want to draw or erase within a certain region without the risk of interfering with other parts of your room. Tile transformations. Tile transformations allow you to change the orientation of a tile or group of tiles. You can mirror and rotate them in various ways, while preserving their tile ID and texture. This is especially useful as a way to get additional tile variation and to reuse existing textures. You can apply tile transformations to your currently selected tile, brush, or selected region. Press the Flip button or the Y key to mirror your tiles vertically. Press the Mirror button or the X key to mirror horizontally. The Rotate Tile button, Z key, will turn your tiles 90 degrees clockwise with each press. You can combine these transformations as well. A couple of things to keep in mind. First, tile transformations of selected regions will override whatever tile their destination ends up being. And second, the Fill tool will ignore transformations and replace all tiles of the same ID that are adjacent. Brushes. Brushes are a very powerful and versatile way of saving and reusing groups of tiles. We can access them by clicking the Brushes tab in the Room Editor window. In this window, you can both create and select brushes to use. Let's start by creating some brushes. Down at the bottom of this window, enable editing mode by clicking this toggle button. It turns this canvas at the bottom into an equivalent of a room, a region where you can place and manipulate tiles. This supports all of the tile tools and features mentioned earlier. Line, rectangle, auto tile, tile selection, tile transformations, and so on. A brush is defined by which tiles are orthogonally adjacent. That means that any tile you place down that is touching another tile in a cardinal direction, up, down, left, or right, will get incorporated into that particular brush. Notably, diagonals don't count for this grouping. Different brushes, therefore, are groups of tiles separated from one another by empty space. This is important to keep in mind in case your pattern includes gaps or diagonal elements. Once you're done creating your patterns, disable editing mode by clicking the toggle button. Now, whenever you click a group of tiles, the editor will select it for you and place it at your cursor with any tile tool you're using. You'll be able to place them in your scene as normal and apply tile transformations to them. One useful feature of brushes that also applies to copied selected tiles, multiple tile selection, and tools with different sizes is that the editor will maintain their spacing when placing them on your scene. For example, if you use the rectangle tool with a 3x3 tile brush, the rectangle will only apply to regions that are multiples of 3, and the pattern will fill the region side by side. This applies to other tile tools as well, such as line and fill. Animated tiles. At last, we have animated tiles. They are a special type of tile grouping, in which static tiles have their sprites cycled through at a given frame rate, to give the illusion of an animation. To create an animation, go to the Libraries tab in the Room Editor window. There, to the right of Animations Library, click the pencil icon. You'll be taken to the Tile Animation window, which, for the scope of this video, we won't dive deeper into. Some useful things to bear in mind. When you create an animation, its first tile, or any tile used only in it, will be treated as animated, even if placed individually in your scene. This can be used to create offset animations, but it also means that you cannot use those tiles statically. You can use the same tile multiple times in a single animation, and even across different animations, but you cannot use a given tile as the first frame in two or more animations. In other words, each animation must have a unique first tile. Tiles used in two or more animations can still be used statically, but only if they are not on the first frame of any of them. All animations in a given tileset have the same animation speed, so if you want an animation to play more slowly, consider doubling the tiles for each frame. Since animated tiles are handled by cycling their sprites at runtime, they are fully compatible with static tiles and are treated the same way by the engine. Their tile IDs are retained even when their sprites cycle, so internally, they are still the same tile you placed initially in your room. It also means that you can create brushes that include animated tiles. And finally, tile transformations are preserved for animated tiles, so if, for example, you rotate an animated tile, all of its frames will have the same rotation. Thank you for watching this video! I hope you learned something new! If you liked this video, consider leaving a like, and if you want to learn more about the Room Editor, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future video tutorials like this. Do you have any questions or tips of your own? Make sure to leave them down in the comments below. Happy game making!